Nobody draws a crowd like each and every one of you here tonight. He does this everywhere he goes, 5,000 in Philadelphia. We don't know how many we have out here today. And I'll say it once, I'll say it again. I mean this from the bottom of my heart. Thank you for coming here tonight. We're not supporting Ron Paul because he is the best candidate. We're supporting Ron Paul because he is the only candidate. Ladies and gentlemen, the next president of the United States, Texas Congressman Ron Paul.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. You have removed my skepticism. and there's no more apathy, right? Well, great. Thank you very much for that very nice welcome. It's a delight to be here. I'm so glad that there are so many who are involved in the real revolution. And it looks like freedom is still very popular. And of course, it looks like we're having some fun. Campaigning should be fun or it'll be boring and that wouldn't be good, but it's great. It's really great. The campaign has been going well. And we've had a great day today. This is the third rally, and there's been a lot of enthusiasm, and it's a real encouragement. They say that I encourage you, but you encourage me. Without you, there is no campaign, and I thank you for that. But the great thing about the campaign is it has brought people out that have not worked together in the past. It really brings people together. And it isn't so much me that brings people together as much as the message of freedom and the Constitution. It does not divide, it brings us all together as Americans. But we do face some very serious problems. We have a few financial problems to deal with. We have foreign policy to deal with, we have monetary policy to deal with, and we have an attack on our civil liberties that we must deal with. But the solution is not that difficult. If we would only respect and follow the Constitution, we could solve all those problems. Probably the first night of the debate, the first debate we had, it was an eye-opener for me because things did change after that. And it is true that probably the foreign policy issue brought attention to our campaign. And that is fine. But many people said they saw the debate, they heard the arguments about the foreign policy, they went and looked at our website, and all of a sudden they looked at all the other issues that we stood for and decided that the whole program looked so good and they joined the campaign. The foreign policy, of course, is a major issue because it is an issue that divides us. I remember the 1960s rather well, very divisive decade. It was a horrible decade when you think about it. The loss of life and the loss of civil liberties and the undermining of our moral fibers in the 60s, it was just a very bad decade. And this is one reason why it's so important to obey the Constitution when it comes to war. Because war is a bad time. It costs a lot of money. It undermines liberty. Then we argue when it lingers. This is why the founders were so explicit about how we would go to war. And they said a president should never take a country to war without permission from the Congress, and there should be a declaration of war. Since World War II, we have been in numerous wars, and hundreds of thousands, if not up to close to a million of deaths and injuries have occurred, and we have not declared a war. We have not won a war. And also, since World War II, we have essentially gone to war under UN resolutions, and that we should never have done. But you know, we were led into war here just a few years ago. They said that it had something to do with 9/11, that there were weapons of mass destruction, and that Hitler was in charge, and we were going to be attacked. And all the stories, it turned out, these stories were not true. If the stories were not true and the war is not going well, it's costing us a lot of money, we can't even fight the war without borrowing from China, I would say it's time to come home. And it certainly is time to drop the idea that we need to take on Iran. We don't need to spread the war. If we would change our foreign policy, we literally could save hundreds of billions of dollars. Not just a couple million, a couple billion, but hundreds of billions of dollars. We have 700 bases overseas. We're in 130 countries, and we're doing exactly what other great nations have done in the past. They spread themselves too thinly around the world, and they finally go bankrupt, and we have to suffer the consequences. Today, the litmus test of our financial condition in this country is the value of the dollar. And the dollar is weak. It's a story that is telling us that we better tighten our belts and change our policy if we want to save our country. One thing about going after all that foreign expenditure, and right now our foreign policy, when you add up everything, costs us nearly $1 trillion a year, so we can save a lot of money. It means that there would be enough money to be able to take care of people here at home without putting anybody out in the streets. But if we start to nickel and dime the people here at home, which they're starting to do, we don't even provide enough money for our veterans. We need to take care of our veterans much better.